to address the board. Please come up to the microphone, state your name and your address, and limit your comments to 3 minutes. Please direct all comments to the board. Per established procedures, we will not respond to questions or interact with the speaker during public comment. Everyone who indicates that they would like follow-up from the district will get follow-up from the appropriate administrator. First up is Doug Lee.
My name is Doug Lee. And I want to just offer this board to think about the direction. We have always been a bricks and mortar community. We have spent the last couple of years I've been here a tremendous amount of money on health risks in infrastructure. We certainly do not bar spending. When it comes to other people's money, which is our tax dollars, we're really good at spending it. One of the things that, no matter what we do in spending, our academic standards continue to shrink. I encourage, with the new superintendent, that we take on some of the superintendent of Dr. Washburn and put academics as a top priority within Forest Hills, instead of just the facade of the buildings. You can do both, walk and chew gum, build buildings, but we can also increase our academic standards and increase the tracking of our academics. We're failing as a school district. Our schools, kids' grades, 11th grade scores are shrinking, and enrollment is shrinking. So our new superintendent is coming in a challenging time. We're going to have empty classrooms. We're already starting to have them now because parents are saying, I'm not putting my kid in public schools because they're not coming out with the quality of education. Sure, we have the buildings, we have the facades, we look good on paper, and we look good in the pictures, but we do a terrible job on academics.
Thank you. Our highest priority, and that our commitment to student safety
age 39, 7 years old. He's on me almost every night. First, it's just in my mouth. Says I can take it. Age 57, he's stinking. The white shit drip off his dick. Lick it, lick it. I hate that.
He came.
Yes.
Stephen, so come on.
I hear him also to talk about the gentleman that was hired, and I was asking if there's going to be any new procedures or policy in regards to hiring, in light of the background check procedures that failed to keep the accused person that was hired as a janitor and allegedly as a fan of child sexual abuse of material.
Since he did not have an arrest or criminal convictions on his record, he was allowed to be hired.
Yet he did have criminal sexual conduct complaint filed against him, which unfortunately was not pursued by the prosecutor.
A step that I'm suggesting
that be taken in the future is for the applicant to sign a waiver form on FHPS letterhead that's notarized, and then in that form would detail
basically a release of police reports and or various records
that can be sent out from the district to various police departments. Those are things that when a police officer gets hired, they get sent out to various departments to see if there has been any type of police contact. Obviously, I know this would be somewhat intensive, but
the case revolving this gentleman before at the massage parlor that was in the news,
that would have showed up in this different background check
because he was not arrested, he was not convicted, there was no record of it in just the standard background checks that are done.
Having that release form should bypass the FOIA requirements, as the applicant is actually giving permission to the school district, in turn to the police departments, to release those records. So since background checks do not work unless the person is actually arrested or convicted, this would be a backstop to make sure that dangerous people do not slip through the cracks and get hired into the district. So that's for that. In regards to the nice, beautiful building there, I do have another ask. Is there any way that the administration could maybe perhaps hold community open houses for whatever one of these large scale buildings and or renovation projects is done? Reason being is community members, taxpayers, I'd like to see how our tax dollars are being spent and what it looks like. Not everyone goes to every single building, but if you have, again, it just has to be like a one day thing. If they make it, then great. If not, oh well. But I mean, I'm sure that building would be nice, but most people will never get to see it, but it costs
several millions of dollars to do it. So Cascade, as a, for instance, Cascade Township just did this when they finished their fire station. It was $7 million. Opened it up to the community. It was a 3-hour event. Everyone got to go through and see, you know, the trucks, the bays, the, you know, their sleeping quarters, everything. It was great. And it was just a good way to show the community, hey, this is where our money, this is where your money went.